In this video, we are going to discuss on assigning point group for the compounds using valential electron pair repulsion theory. Very often in the competitive exam, they give a molecule and they ask for the point group of that. In order to predict the point group, first you should know the structure of that compound. To predict the structure, we use valential electron pair repulsion theory. You may know, when you go for valential electron pair repulsion theory and the structure, you have to consider only the number of bond pairs and lone pairs. So you have to look for the sum of bond pairs and lone pairs. These bond pairs and lone pairs, they are placed around a sphere, that is basically atom, in such a way that there will be least repulsion between them. Say the sum of bond pairs and lone pairs is 3. Then the arrangement of these 3 around a sphere will be like this. When I place the 3 bond pairs around the sphere like this, the repulsion between them will be very less. The angle, it will be 120. Basically, it is trigonal planar. It need not be always 3 bond pairs. One bond pair can be replaced with one lone pair. That is, 2 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. In such case, what we get is something like this. One bond has been replaced with lone pair. This is nothing but carbene. What will be the point group of this? For this trigonal planar, the point group is D3H. You can imagine a triangle. What will be the symmetry elements here? There will be E, there will be C3, and there will be 3C2. If these are present, then you can say it is D3 point group. C3 axis, it is from the top. Through this, I can rotate by 120 to get the same structure. C2 is through this. Through this, I can rotate by 180 to get the same. In addition to that, it has sigma H since it is planar molecule. So it is D3H. If it is triangle, then it will be D3H. If it is square, it will be D4H. If it is pentagon, it will be D5H. If it is hexagon, then it will be D6H. It goes like that. A planar molecule, which is symmetrical, will have DNH point group. What about this? Basically, it is carbene. The shape is bent shape or V shape. You may be very familiar with this shape. Another most common example is water. So water also has the same structure. Instead of carbon, we have oxygen in water. So the point group for this, you may know, it is C2V. The symmetry elements present in this will be E, C2, sigma XZ, sigma YZ. The sum of bond pairs and lone pairs is 4. Then what are the possibilities are there? All the 4 can be bond pair. First possibility. Second one, 3 may be bond pair, 1 may be lone pair. Next possibility, 2 bond pair plus 2 lone pair. If there are four bond pairs, then what is the most preferred structure? It is very simple. It is tetrahedral. When you go for tetrahedral arrangement, the distance between the two bond pair will be the maximum. It will be 109. If you go for square planar, the distance between the bond pairs will be only 90. But here it is 109, that is the maximum distance the atoms can arrange themselves around the central atom. You may know the point group of tetrahedral molecule is TD. When it is three bond pairs and one lone pair, still the geometry will be same. Instead of one hydrogen, I am going to place one lone pair. That is the only difference. For example, I go for nitrogen in place of carbon. I have not changed the geometry. Still, it is tetrahedral. The lone pair will be here. But when you go for the structure, we consider only the bond pairs. So this, if you consider, this will be trigonal pyramidal. When you go for two lone pairs and two bond pairs, still it is tetrahedral. The geometry is tetrahedral, but in that, two are lone pairs. You can see, this shape is bent shape. For simplicity, generally we write like this. But basically, it is tetrahedral. But the angle between this hydrogen and this hydrogen is 109. Between this hydrogen and this, it is 109. But when you go for ammonia, even though it is tetrahedral geometry, this will be less than 109. It won't be 109. The reason, the repulsion between this lone pair and bond pair is higher than the repulsion between bond pair. That is basically valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Even though the geometry is same, the angle will not be same. Now, what will be the point group of this? You may know for water, it is C to V. It has E, C2, sigma XZ, sigma YZ. There will be four symmetry elements. I can write this in this fashion also. C2 plus 2 sigma V. Both this, they are sigma V. So it comes under C2V. C2 plus 2 sigma V is C2V. Similarly here, there will be E, C3 and 3 sigma V. The C3 axis will go through this and there will be 3 planes which can divide the molecule into 2 equal halves. Because of that, it is C3V. Say, the sum of lone pair and bond pair is 5. Then, what is the most preferred structure? Geometry. It is nothing but trigonal bipyramidal. These three, they are in one plane and these two are perpendicular to that. Basically, this particular portion is similar to trigonal planar. the trigonal planar, I have placed one atom on the top, one at the bottom. Say it is Cl atoms, so it is nothing but PCl5. This is the most preferred geometry. The angle between this will be 120, similar to trigonal planar, and the angle between this Cl and this Cl will be 90. This is the most preferred arrangement in which the steric hindrance will be less. Here, all are bond pairs. I didn't consider any lone pair. Now, suppose if there is one lone pair, say there are four bond pairs and one lone pair. What will happen? I have to place that here. Once again, the geometry, it is trigonal bipyramidal. I have not changed that. You can see, I have not changed. I have placed a lone pair in the place of chlorine. I have not done anything extra. Now, if you see, the structure, whatever we call it, is seesaw. You might have played in seesaw. The kids sit on the seesaw and they play. So this is the middle which supports the slab. So this structure is similar to this. So that is why we call it seesaw. Now suppose if there are three bond pairs and two lone pairs, I have to place one more here. So the structure becomes like this. Since this angle already mentioned, it is 90, and between this it will be 180. So the structure will be something like this. That is nothing but T shape. Suppose if there are two bond pairs and three lone pairs, what will happen? I have to place one more lone pair here. In that case, this will become a linear structure. Now, what is the point group of this? This point group will be D3H. D3 refers to C3 plus 3C2. It is nothing but sigma h. You can find all these three here. C3 goes through this. 3C2, that is through this axis and through this and through this. There are 3C2. And sigma h, it will be in the plane of the triangle. Since it is symmetrical on the top as well as at the bottom, when you go for sigma h, you will get the same molecule. So because of that, it is D3H. What about this? It is C-sharp. This is C2V. There will be C2 plus 2 sigma V. I will come to that later. What about the T-shape? This also, it is C2V. There will be C2 and 2 sigma V. Suppose if the sum of bond pairs and lone pairs, say it is 6, what is the most preferred geometry? Anybody can say very easily, it is octahedral. The structure of octahedral will be like this. See, in the middle we have some atom. At the 6 corners we will have same atom. Then what we get is octahedral shape. So basically it is square pyramidal placed one over the other. Now in this case all 6 are bond pairs. If we go for one lone pair and 5 bond pair, In such case, I have to replace this with lone pair. What I get is, here, say I have lone pair. Easily you can identify this is square pyramidal. Suppose if I go for two lone pairs, then the most preferred arrangement is like this. So it becomes square planar. So now, what is the point group for these compounds? Here, you may know it is octahedral. It is very simple. Since the structure is octahedral, I give OH. The square pyramidal, it is C4V. If it is pyramidal, C3V. Now it is C4V. If it is pentagonal pyramidal, it will be C5V. What about square planar? Triangle, it is D3H. Square planar, it will be D4H. So if you notice, most of the compounds will come under CNV point group, DNH point groups. These two are the most common point groups for most of the molecules. At this point, I want to give one important information. That is, if you substitute a structure symmetrically with respect to all the class of operation, then the point group will be same. For example, consider the water molecule. Say this is towards us and the hydrogen is going back. It has four symmetry operations. E, C2, sigma XZ and sigma YZ. Now what I do, I substitute something here. I introduce some atom. I have not symmetrically substituted with mirror plane as well as C2. If I rotate this by 180 degree, the X will come this side. So it is not symmetrically substituted. On the other hand, if I substitute the same atom this side also, then the point group of this will be C2V and water, that also C2V. So basically the structure what we get is C-sum. I can give one more example, that is PCl5. And BCl3. This is trigonal planar, trigonal bipyramidal. I have substituted two atoms which is symmetric with respect to all the class of operation. It has C3, C2, sigma V, sigma H, S3. You go for any of this operation, these two will be symmetric. If you go for C2 through this, this Cl will come here, this Cl will come down. If you go for sigma H, once again they will get exchanged. So I have substituted symmetrically with respect to all the symmetry operations. In such case, the point group will not change. I go for one more example. This is bend shape, you may know. To this bend shape, what I do, I am going to introduce two atoms like this. For bend shape, it is C to V. When I substitute symmetrically here, say I have substituted two atoms. With respect to the four classes of operation, it is symmetric. Also, what I do, I substitute two more here. Say they also A. Once again, with respect to all the class of operation, it will be symmetric. You can try E, C2. If you rotate through this axis, say these are X. This X will come here, this will come here, this will go here, this will come this side. So with respect to C2, it is symmetric. Similarly, if you go for sigma XZ, sigma YZ, it will be symmetric. For example, if you go for some metal atom here and the tetrahedral complex. So basically, this is the tetrahedral structure, which has two different ligand here. Say it is CL and the remaining it is BR. The point group will be C2V. I have substituted symmetrically with respect to all the class of operation. The point group will not change. If you have taken the same atom here also, then that will become octahedral. Say instead of X, I have A. Then the molecule will be octahedral.
Not if you explain this,
but when they are different,
I go for the model,
it will be C2V. Basically, this is trigonal planar. All the atoms will be in the same plane. The total number of bond pairs are 3. If I replace one bond pair with lone pair, say this is lone pair, then the structure, whatever I get, will be V-shaped. The angle may not be 120 exactly, but still the shape, the structure will be V-shaped or bent shape. Now let us go for tetrahedral shape. This is basically tetrahedral. When you place on the surface, only these three atoms will touch the surface. The middle one, the red color, it will not touch. CH4 is tetrahedral in structure. Now I replace one bond pair with lone pair. This one considered as lone pair. Now the structure, it is pyramidal. Suppose if I replace one more bond pair with lone pair, then what I get is bent shape or V shape. I go for the next one, that is trigonal bipyramidal. This is basically trigonal bipyramidal. You can see a trigonal planar on the top as well as at the bottom. We have two more atoms. In this, the number of bond pairs are 5. If I replace this one with lone pair, then the structure will be seesaw. You can see here, I can play like a kid. This structure is seesaw. Suppose if I replace one more bond pair with lone pair, then the structure, whatever I get, is T shape. If I replace one more, then the structure, whatever I get, will be linear. Next one, I go for octahedral. This is octahedral shape. It is highly symmetrical. If I replace one bond pair with lone pair, then the geometry, whatever I get, will be like this. So basically, it is square pyramidal. From here, I can connect. So what I get is square pyramidal, it will be C4V. If I replace one more, it will become a planar, square planar.